So after covering the basic rule of counting, including generalized rule of counting, we can come to the second topic of this chapter, which is permutations. Permutations is an important concept in doing combinatorial analysis. And let's start with a simple example. How many different arrangements of the letters A, B, C? Notice that you have three letters and they're all different. And we consider arrangement of sorting or arranging the letters A, B, C. If you start from scratch, you can imagine that you have three different positions to fill, and each position gonna be filled by one of the letters. So if you have three different letters to start with, and we try to fill the position one by one, that means for the first position, you have three different choices because you have three different letters. And once you go to the second position, because you already have chosen one letter for the first position, so you're only left with two letters for the second position. And once you move to the third position here, you're only gonna get one choice because the first two already have taken the other two. In short, if we're gonna use what we covered earlier about the generalized rule of counting, you will have three times two times one numbers of arrangements. And if you do the math, it's gonna be six. And notice that we're using a particular notation here. So this three exclamation mark, we read it as three factorial. A factorial, so for three factorial, it's three times two times one. Okay, for any integer number, the number of factorial will be the number times number minus one times number minus two until one. So as another example, five factorial will be five times four times three times two times one. Okay? So for example, if we're gonna have five different letters A, B, C, D, E, then the number of different arrangements for A, B, C, D, E gonna be five factorial, following the same logic. So with this simple example, I want to cover that each of this arrangement, it's a permutation. And keep in mind that for a permutation, the order matters because ABC is different from BAC. And if you have n different or distinct objects, then the number of permutations is going to be n factorial. Okay, just like what we see here with three different letters, you're gonna have three factorial, which is six, number of arrangements. And based on the definition, it's gonna be the number of permutations. All right, so with that in mind, let's consider this exercise. Number of permutations of the letters in the word Facebook. Keep in mind that what we just covered now is the number of permutations should be n factorial if you have n different objects. However, notice that here for Facebook, you do have eight letters, but in fact, two of them are duplicates. You have two O's here. So n factorial directly wouldn't work, but how can you make it work? Thinking about the definition of permutations and then how to compute the number of permutations, and you have two duplicate letters. All right, so you have three different choices here. Think creatively as how you can do the workout based on the definition of permutations and then complete the exercise.